In this video, we are trying to find out how we can test two different values. You see we have a profit value and a stop loss value here. And we want to find out how to test different values in an advanced backtesting series in the strategy tester. Our expert advisor will have two different values that can be changed without recompiling the code. And we are going to test several combinations. To do that, please click on the little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the Metaeditor window, and here you want to click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file SimpleCombinedOptimization, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Let's remove everything above the onTick function and the two command lines. First, we create an instance of C-trade. To do that, we use the include statement for the trade MQH file, and the instance for our C-trade class will be called trade. In this simple example, we will test two variables, one for the profit, the other one for the stop loss value. The input modifier defines external variables, and as you see, they can be changed only from the program properties window. I have used the default value for the take profit and the stop loss here. Let's get the ask and the bid price. That is done by using symbol info double for the current symbol on the chart. Symbol underscore ask will deliver the ask price. Symbol underscore bid will deliver the bid price. And with normalized double and underscore digits, we get the right number of digits behind the dot. We also will need to have the balance and the equity to see if we make a loss or a profit. Both values can be calculated by using account info double. Account underscore balance will give us the balance, and account underscore equity will give us the equity. And if we have no open positions, so if positions total equals zero, we want to open a buy trade and a sell trade, each for 10 microlot. And we will use the stop loss values and the profit values. At the end, we will use the command function to create a chart output. This is how it looks like in the strategy tester. And that's about it. This is a really simple example, just to create anything that can be backtested. So please don't use it on your real account. I promise you, you will lose all your money, because this is how the results look like. So let's stop the strategy tester here. Now let's compile the code. And that worked without any errors. So now we go back to MetaTrader by clicking on the little button here or pressing the F4 key. And in MetaTrader, you want to click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. And here in the Strategy Tester, we are going to use the optimization, the fast generic based algorithm. Click on the Inputs tab. Let's mark the My Take Profit value here. Go back to Settings and start a test. And you will see that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 results here. Now let's go back to the Inputs tab. Also mark the My Stop Loss value and repeat the test. And this time it's going to do 48 tests. The reason is that we have two values. And now our backtesting will check out all the possible combinations. I started with a value of 15 for the my take profit value. I wanted to stop the optimization at 25. The step value is 2, so it will test every other value. You see, these are the values for 15. The next one is for 17. For the my stop loss value, the step is 15. So if I sort by that, you will see that it goes from 150 to 165, all the way up to 255. That's because 250 minus 150 is 100, and 100 cannot be divided by 15 without a remainder. So MetaTrader has no other choice to go from 240 to 255. Now I have changed the values. We are going to test from a start value of 150 up to 160 for the take profit and the stop loss value. That will be 121 combinations. So let's go back to settings, restart the test. This will take a few seconds. And here are our results. Now you could export everything to an XML file for your spreadsheet calculation. Let's do that here. And this is how it looks like. Okay, now you know how you can test several different variables in a single backtesting session. And you can create your testing code with a few lines of MQL5 code. Just use the input modifier for each value you want to test.